Welcome back, everybody, to some more Mountain Blade Warband, and this is going to be a part four, and where you last left off, guys, we spoke to the king about becoming a vassal for his kingdom, and he told us that we needed to go out and prove ourselves and take down his enemy. And right now, when we ended the last episode, guys, the Nords had just started a war with the Swadians, which are these in the orange here, so we're just going to travel to the borders and see what kind of trouble we can get into. If we're careful, we should be able to take one of their lords down with lower numbers than we have. We're going to try to recruit along the way to kind of beef ourselves up a little bit. We have pretty low-tier troops right now, guys. They're just a little bit above the first levels, so they could use some experience for sure. So the travel over here should give them a little time to beef themselves up a little bit. And we're also wanting to go grab Matheld as soon as we have the money for it. So we're going to try to cover all of that in this episode, guys. Prove to the king a little bit that we can handle business, and maybe he will, you know, bestow vassalship onto us. That would be great. So right now we got 57 men. We're looking pretty good. Let's see what's going on at the border up here. I'm sure the Swadians are going to want to make a move as soon as they possibly can. I'm just kind of wondering what they might be eyeballing that the Nords have, because I think it would be that the Swadians want something that the Nords have, vice versa, the Nords wanting something the Swadians have. So we're going to work our way out to Ribalet Castle here, cross enemy territory. Of course, the beauty of this is right now, guys, is we're not signed on with the Nords right now, so there's some action over there at that town. We'll head over that way. So we can go right up onto the Swadians and it just be like, hey, what's going on? And then all of a sudden we could turn it on them and, you know, tell them, you know, demand them surrender. And then we'll be on their shit list, so to speak. And then we can go to start going to war with them. So there is, so Nords are starting trouble with them. So we're going to kind of just follow Gutland's party and see what happens. Maybe bail him out if we possibly can. Let's see, who's in this castle? Count Regis is in this castle with only 23 men, so let's just see what Gutland's up to here. The Kirgites and the Vigers made peace. Well, good for them. They can lick their wounds a little bit. Alright, so now we have some action. We have Nords, we have Clargus. Clargus's party at 59 men, and if we want to, let's check our, we can level up our Vigor recruits that we just grabbed not too long ago to footmen. And basically, guys, our company right now kind of is compromised of a bunch of archers, really. I mean, we have a couple Vigor horsemen training to be knights, but other than ourselves, that's basically all the cavalry we have. So pretty basic military right now. And I guess I'll move these recruits up. We'll put them above the horsemen so that they're spawned in and they can take some of the heat. And let's see what Clargus got running here. He's got 7 men at arms, so those are basically a tier away from being knights, top tier. So they're about second top. 3 crossbowmen, bunch of footmen. Got skirmishers, 12 of them. So they've got a nice little balance. So maybe we can lure Clargus into Gutland's party. Get Gutland to join with us. Maybe not. Because, I mean, we have 57 men. We could take on Clargus's company right now and just see what happens. Dang, he is just straight up outrunning me. So let's pop into Suno real quick. And we'll go to the tavern. We'll see if there's anybody we can hire. There's a book merchant. We'll get back to that. There's Atmir. Let's see, how much does he want? He's an engineer. He specializes in engineering. So it would be profitable for us to hire him on because he could help us with sieges and stuff. So he needs to go to some town. But Goria? But first he would like to explore for a while. So we'll hire him for 300 dinars, sure. So now we have Adamir. He's a pretty handy guy. Let's see, watchman. How many are there? 4 for 188, sure. We'll hire those guys too. Get them in our company. Anything upstairs? No? Okay. So we'll scoot out of here. Let's check our food supplies real quick. We're running a little light, maybe, for 60 men, so grab a couple things. And we still have about 900 bucks we're sitting on. I did do a little bit of fighting in between episodes, guys, and then I brought it back to the capital there before I started this episode. But now we have... How many do we have? We have 60 men against his 59. He's not interested in us right now because we're not at war with anybody. So let's get Adamir, or whatever his name. I'm not sure exactly on the pronunciation of all these guys. So you just have to bear with me. But we're going to put him right underneath us. It's a named character in the game. I like to refer to him as like heroes, basically. They're heroes that can join your company and you can level them up and stuff. And kind of like, you know, you a bunch of yous. So they're very convenient and helpful. So we'll back out of that now. And let's just see what Clargus is going to do. Really tempted to take him on. I think it would even be worth it, guys, if I took him on, won the battle, but yet lost a lot of men in doing so. Just because we can rebuild our men, but we'll gain a lot of prestige and renown with the king if we do this. Maybe even get vassalship. So tempted. I mean, we have Adamir. We have us. We've got a bunch of archers. We've got a bunch of ground troops. It's just his men-at-arms that I'm concerned about. He has only 7 of them, so... I say, screw it, guys. Let's do this. We're going to go after Clargus. Introduce ourselves. Yeah, we have a nobleman's banner. We are just plaguing everybody with questions with our banner, it seems. So now, guys, we're going to go down here because we're at peace with him. We just have, like, the basic dialogue options. Like, where is somebody? What are you up to? Nice to meet you. That good stuff. But also we have, I'm here to deliver you my demands. And then he's just going to be like, what? And we're going to offer him a chance to surrender. He's going to get pissed about that. Insulted, in fact. And we're going to try to take him on, guys. So here's to all of the luck in the world. This would be like our first big challenge. So let's just see how we fare, guys. We're going to hold everybody here. Set up formations. I'm doing this very quickly, guys, because... He's on a cavalry base, yeah, and they are already coming. So he is creeping a little bit, which is convenient. Give my archers a chance to actually take some shots at him. Maybe score a few deaths. I would imagine. Yeah, let's send our infantry after them, kind of hold them back a little bit so our archers have time to do their jobs. We are going to go on top of this hill. Kind of scope, God. All right. We better start getting to work, actually. Yeah, totally missed that guy. Just going to jump right into the crowd of them, guys. Yeah, we are just full on now. Going to go ahead and just get everybody else to charge. They're taking some damage doing this. Gosh, it's a night. Or that was a men-at-arms, at least. Oh, come on. And just not scoring anything. There we go. see, Clargus got knocked unconscious, so their lord's down. That's good. Now, if I can just manage to stay conscious myself, we might be able to pull this off. Hopefully Adamir is still conscious. I think that might be him. I need to get out of this blob, though, before I get taken down. Just gonna kind of climb the top of the hill here. Take some of these archers out. Oh, you dick with the pike. Yeah, my arm is just bloody as hell. I bet that whole side of me is just bloody. Must take these guys down, though. Give my men some assistance here. Archers seem to be doing okay still. Oh, we've got this men-at-arms or knight over here causing trouble. If I can catch him. I am about to go down myself. I just noticed my health. Looks like we're swarming them, though. You know what? I'm gonna back off for a second, actually. Let's try to get guy here. We're on a... Ooh. Yeah. Tricky. If I can even get him off of his horse, it would be great. There we go. On the ground. Come on, boys. Oh. Gotcha. All right. Should be about wrapped up. They did great, I think. I think our little lower tier army did just great. So we must have like one straggler here or something. Really bad shot there, buddy. And you're done. Try to get a jump kill. Ah! Missed it. These frontline troops of mine, though, they're doing pretty good. So there's another. Here we go. He's done. I missed him. Let my guy finish him off, I guess. And there it is. The cry of victory. Alright, so we did take significant losses on that, I think, as I expected we were going to. Ooh, 33. Ouch. 22 wounded, so at least we know we have 22 men left. That's a good thing. And we wiped out practically his whole cavalry. Two were injured, which I would imagine's him and maybe some other, like a knight or something. We've got a men-at-arms we can capture. That's good. Bunch of gear. Is this better than mine? No, it is not. Okay. Bunch of gear we can collect so we can sell. Like I said, every penny counts when you're first starting out. And alright, that's all we can hold. We actually got 660 dinar for that one. We leveled up to level 7 now. We have men ready to upgrade. We're down to 27. We did take a great hit on that, but now we've accomplished our mission, guys, within the fact that we've proven to the king, hopefully now, that we can handle business. We are now kind of enemies with the Swadians for the time being, so we're just going to kind of dip the hell out as soon as we can. Let's see, we'll head towards Jopegi Castle. What is this, sir? Just so you know, my opinion, any commander with sense will not let this company turn every battle into a bloodbath for our side. I hope you don't mind me speaking so bluntly. So, Artemir, you are a little bit of a whiner. I'm gonna just kind of shut him up for right now. I may have to cut him loose if he's not down with what we do here, so... And what we do here is we just do what we have to accomplish. Really, you're 7.
We can do this the easy way, with a hot one.
There's no need to fight. I don't think so. Yeah, we're going to... Oh, because there's only five of us that are well enough to fight. I see. I was wondering why seven raiders were approaching our fifth or our 27. And now I have my answer. So, you know what? I have enough life in me to take a couple of good hits. I think I'm going to take a couple down here before they get to my guys to kind of even the odds. Yeah, with your little archers. Okay. He's done. That was a good knock. Ooh. And keep missing them. Maybe I'm going to take a couple down. Jeez. There we go. Yeah, it seems like my men are handling them anyways, so that's good. Ah, figured I'd get off my guy. Trying not to die. There we go. Sure, I'll take both of you. Die. And you still want some, dude? Wow, this guy is taking it. Hire him myself. Jeez, I still did not take him down. I can't believe that. It's like last man standing. Got archers shooting at him. Oh, never mind. That's an archer shooting at me, and I am about to go down. I took him. Wow, they still both are determined. Oof. Heard that one. That was not good. Okay, one more swipe ought to do it. Oh, I missed him. And did not that time, though. I think that's it. Is there another guy? Don't tell me there's a couple left. Oh, no, okay. Whew. Well, they took out my five that were still ready for battle, four of them actually, but I did finish them all off, and we should be, yeah, we're maxed out on room. Alright, if our 23 could actually get healed back up, we'll be okay. So, hurting as we are, I'm just going to kind of creep along here for a minute, give our troops a little time to heal themselves a little. And we'll slowly make our way to, back to Nord territory, or at least Swadian territory. Well, out of Swadian territory, but kind of rebuild. Maybe we'll go back to the king, see if that's good enough. I don't know if he would be at the castle now because they're at war, so let's see how many men are ready to go here. Only two still. Eh. Those nine might just catch us. Alright, Kyrgyz and Serenids are done. They have made peace with each other. I think the Serenids are at war with a couple people anyways. So we're going to head into this castle. And let's see. Yeah, we'll go into the castle. We'll go to the Lord's Hall. Is anybody home? There's a lady here. So let's actually ask her where the king is. At your service, ma'am. Lord Mark, it is. Alright, we're not going to hit on her. We're going to ask her where King Ragnar is, and he is near Telrog Castle at the moment. So maybe the Swadians are trying to siege that. What we want to do right now is we're going to spend at least like a night here, guys, and kind of heal back up so that our 20-something men are 20-something men and not two. Oh, man, whoa. There goes everybody right now. We're going to try to catch them, actually. Let's see if the king's even in here. Is that the king? No, it isn't. No, it isn't. Oh, come on, let me get zoomed on the other guy. Oh, yeah, Gunder. Turrot. So they're all heading somewhere, but we kind of want to go to Telrog and look for the king. So that's what we're going to do. Matter of fact, Who's this? This is Tarigar. We're gonna go to Helbeggy real quick. Grab some more recruits. There we go, four more. How many of us are ready to go? 22 of us are ready to go, so we're in good shape. We're gonna hit Kine real quick, and then we'll head over to Telrog. If we don't pass the king in kind of this little travel anyways, because everybody seems to be going that direction. So two from Kine. All right. Let's go out here to the field in Sargoth, and who do we have here? We've got, you know what, I'm going to try to catch him. Wait, there's the king. Let's go speak to the king, guys. All right, he's probably going back to recruit anyway. Go into the castle. Let's see what the king has to say. See if we've proven ourselves enough yet. So Lady Ilsna, Lady Agesa, Aneth. All right, King Ragnar. And he still doesn't really like us any, and I think that's really what determines it. First, but we're going to... Alright, you are known as a brave man-at-arms and fine leader. A fine leader of men, Lord Mark. I shall be pleased. Nice. He's going to accept us without even liking us at all. So, we've done well to build up a little rep already. So, that's nice. I am ready. Yes, we are. I pledge myself to you. I will remain loyal to you. Blah, blah, blah. And such, I will be your sword. Okay, sir. It says, very well. Have given me your solemn oath, Lord Mark. May you uphold it always with proper courage and devotion. All right. Let it be known from this day forward, you are my sworn man and vassal. I give you my protection and grant you right to bear arms in my name. I pledge that I shall not deprive you of your life, liberty, or properties except by the lawful judgment of your peers or by the law and custom of the land. Furthermore, I give you the fief of nice Meshen for all its rents and revenues. Nice. So he gives us a town right away. So we have just became a lord under the kingdom of the Nords, guys, under King Ragnar. We've accomplished that in this episode, so that's good. We've also been gifted a fief or a town. So, yeah, thank you, sir. Have great hopes of you, Lord Mark. And you should prove yourself worthy of my trust as I place in you. Okay. So, cool. We have just received vassalship and a town, guys. So, not bad at all. So, we are technically in the faction of the Nords now, so we are technically at war with Swadians. So that is exactly what we will be doing, guys. And actually, let me check the tavern real quick. We got Watchmen. We have Aelin here, but I'm not too fond of Aelin. I've only used him, I think, once, but he was kind of like Adamir. He was kind of a whiner over everything that we did. And... there's a merchant from Sargoth still. Ah, Lord Mark, things didn't go quite as well as that I'd hoped. King Ragnar couldn't find it in him to overlook my little breach of the peace. Oh, he's grateful enough that I get rid of his crooked captain, a guard who let in an enemy army. If the price is right, but he can't exactly... what does he say? He can't exactly an enemy army. What? But he can't exactly have me running around here as lasting remainder of his failure to take care of himself. So, yeah, I can see kind of the king's point on that. Not going to cover any more of dude's story. He's just going to kind of disappear off of the face of the earth, basically. Or Calradia, for that. And we won't really see him anymore, so... alright, so we are done with the king, speaking with him. We've got 29 men, 26 ready to go. We're going to run around and... ooh, this is being raided right now. Let's see what we're up against here. Oh, we are up against a lot. Oh, wait. Never mind, that's one of ours. Raymald's party has 80 going. And did he just scare off... who is raiding this. I think he did, yeah. So we have just lords all over the place right here. Of course, it is our capital. It's near our capital city, basically, Sargoth, so that's understandable. Let's go up to Vayeg, whatever it is. And, okay, so all our lords. That's good, good, good. I think I see a Swadian over there, but he has 75 men, so we are not even ready for that business yet. 73, and that's a Vigor anyway, so he doesn't concern us. Alright, so this, we're entering Vigor territory. We could go over to Ambien, but I think... Not sure if it's this playthrough or not, guys. Sorry, I've done so many different files or different playthroughs on this game. It's kind of hard to remember which one's which sometimes. But, okay, so we have 34. I guess we'll go into Vigor territory for the moment. Go to Ismarala. Ismarala. Jeez. We'll recruit some Vigors. Vigors are good like Nords are in the sense of kind of like their top tier ground troops are pretty tough, like their footmen and everything. So we can grab some Vigor recruits. We could also, they also make decent knights too. That's the only other faction that really has something considered a knight like the Swadians have there. Knights of Cavalry, and then the Vigors have a top tier horseman cavalry that they call Vigor Knights, so it's pretty cool. We'll go up here to Rabachi. I think we can kind of cruise a little now, shouldn't be too concerned about bandits. And we'll grab six men from them. And I think let's hit Sambuja. We'll hit Sambuja, and then we'll end the episode, guys, at Revidin. Alright. And we'll just kind of pitch a tent right outside Revidin here, guys. Let's see who's this. Okay, Vigor. And we have 43 men now. We've received vassalship under the kingdom of the Nords. King Ragnar's pretty pleased with us, even though he doesn't really like us. There's their king. The Vigor's King, 204, not bad. And, so, yeah, let's check our party now. So everybody is ready to level up, so that's good. At least go up a tier, you know, so they're a little more experienced for when we're ready for them again. Let's see, Huntsman or Footman. I'm gonna go Footman. Wanna get some ground troops going. Our archer situation's kind of doing all right. Got a couple more horsemen there. That's good. We got a couple veterans. Nice. Let's see what we get out of the recruits here. Two more footmen. Not bad. And I'll probably realign all of this on my own time in between episodes, guys, and kind of get our cavalry with our cavalry, so on and so forth. I think I'm going to end this episode here, guys, and when we come back, we will continue to fight against the Swadians and kind of push maybe our territory into theirs a little bit more, capture some castles and towns for our king, and maybe he will bestow some of them on us so we can start bringing in some decent money. So, yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this, and we'll leave off here, guys, and get back to it when we come back. But until then, have a nice day.